So hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to do a review of this WISELAZER projector. I just want to mention the video is not sponsored by the company. I purchased it on Amazon, as you can see over here. So let's get into the unboxing. The first impression when I see the box compared to the price that I paid, I'm not really satisfied because it looks quite cheap. Is this cardboard just printed? On the other side is the same thing, but the most important is the product. So let's open this one and see what's inside. So this is how you open it. And inside you see there is a carrying case, and this is how it looks, and it has a nice zip here in the middle. And this is the interior. From what I can see, I'm not really satisfied with the quality. It's not so impressive. Here is the user manual and with the branding. And if we open it, there is a protective foil, and I'll show you what's left in the carrying case. We have obviously the power cable for the UK. We have a filter, I think. Yeah, it seems like a filter. We have the remote control, which is quite basic, I suppose. Doesn't come with batteries, but we're gonna have a look at this. We have the HDMI cable, and basically that's it. This other remote control looks like a bit closer. It feels good quality. Here is the mic. I'm not really sure what this one does, but it's really interesting to see that there is this feature on a remote control, and as I said, it comes without batteries, so you'll need two AAA small batteries. So now let's have a look at the projector. Has a really interesting pattern here on the top. I'm pretty sure this one is not the speaker, and also the menu buttons are quite interesting. They are made from rubber, so quite easy to press. And also the finger doesn't slide. So these are the ports on the projector. There is the power port. We have two USBs, but I think these ones are USB 2.0 based on the color. We have one HDMI, and the second HDMI we have the jack port for the audio. And here is the sensor to operate the projector with the remote control. And here at the back we have the speaker, and the ventilation is on the other side. As we can see, I'm not really sure how to change the filter for this one. I think you have to open it. And this is the front, pretty basic. Here's the sensor, and here's the cover, which surprisingly it's very bad quality. It's just like a rubber, and it doesn't even stay properly, because when you move it like this it can flip very, very easy. So this is the back of the projector. Has four anti-slip legs. It has this wheel in the middle, it's like a screw inside. I'm not really sure what this one does, but it's extremely disappointing to see that there is no adapter for the tripod, as most of the projector have. And on this side, if we open this container, we can see that there is the filter compartment, and we also got a spare one. So this is a really interesting feature, I would say, add-on. But the most important is to see how this one performs, so let's put it to test. So in order to make this work, what you have to do is to plug obviously the power cable, and to attach the HDMI into the device and then into your laptop, and more or less I think that's it. So once you attach the power cable and the HDMI, basically you have to turn it on with the button is over here, and you'll instantly hear the sound of the ventilation, which is here at the back. So now I'll guide you through the menu. Basically what you have to do is to use the keys on the projector to navigate, as you can see, left, right. Or you can use also the remote control, and in our case, because we want to connect the laptop, we basically have to press OK on the HDMI and then select the source. Here at the back you can see there is HDMI 1 and 2, and we're gonna select HDMI 1, and the image should start now. I just played a movie on Amazon, and this is the quality. Of course the projector is very close to the wall, so the image is very compressed. I didn't find any other place to put it. I have removed the sound of the movie just for you guys to hear how noisy this projector is. I moved the microphone a bit closer. Here in the settings section we can see the Wi-Fi, the Bluetooth, projector image setting, and other options. Obviously you can connect your smartphone using your Wi-Fi network, and you can operate this projector using your smartphone, which I think is pretty cool. So final thoughts about this projector. I don't actually like the box. The presentation is cheap. The projector itself, it's nicely built, the top and the menu, but considering that at the front the lens, lens cover is from rubber, and it looks also quite cheap on the sides. The remote control is fine, and the functionalities of the product are good, but I don't like that I cannot connect it to my tripod, so basically to display it anywhere I want to. I hope I found this video helpful, guys. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below and I will answer. Thank you for watching and see you next time.